know me, probably the grade 10s here. I'm Ashley Reese. I was the co-president of Grad Council last year. And I just wanted to start off this fantastic evening that Grad Council's organized this year with our grad gift to the school from 2008. And we decided to donate to a charity that a few former students from Otsegona are involved in. It's called the Kenyan Ceramic Project, and I'd like to invite Allison Richmond and Jessica Hogan up here. They're involved with the charity. They're just going to tell you a bit more about it, and I'd like to give them this check for all of their efforts. So if you'd like to come up here.
On behalf of the Kenyan Ceramic Project, I'd like to say thank you very quickly about what the project is. By the way, we're both alumni. I'm an alumnus of 2003, and you're from which year?
2005.
Yeah. Okay, so I started the project 2 years ago with medical students at the time, first-year medical students. And the project is really about two things. It's about providing clean and safe water, drinking water to people in Kenya, where it's about almost half the people there don't have access to clean drinking water. And the second part of that project, which might seem a bit strange to you, is to provide higher efficiency cooking stoves to these people. So it's a design that was developed by physicist emeritus at U of A, Dr. Lightman. And he initially had a stove designed for camping trips for backpackers. We've adapted it for clay use for potters in Kenya. So it started in 2007. I spent about 8 months in Kenya as the project manager there. And the project continues. We have more and more members. We currently have two members there at the moment. Your donation of $1,000, or the grad class's donation of $1,000, is a huge amount of money, especially when you consider how far that money can go in somewhere like Kenya. So, for example, right now we're just shipping over a new piece of equipment that's going to help us increase the speed with which we can create these water filters, and that's a little over $1,000. So that's something that you've essentially paid for. Another thing that we're doing is we're changing the wiring. We're going from one phase to three phase electrical power. That means anything to anybody in the small village where we have our second startup factory. And what that means is that we have the ability to work with high efficiency machinery and motors that can really increase our throughput. So it's making a big difference, and that wiring is costing us about $1,000 as well. So those are the kinds of things that this money can help us with, and we're very much appreciative. When we started out, we had essentially our own personal budgets, and so we really stretch every dollar. So we assure you that thank you so much for this. It's really going to go a long way. I also want to mention Jessica is going to talk to you a bit about an upcoming fundraiser we have.
Just a few seconds, because I'm telling you the lights, Mrs. Burke's probably going to be the evil eye you guys all are very familiar with. a big thing that we have coming up is another way to raise funds. It's the second annual Kenya Run for Water. Last year was a really fun day. A lot of people came out, university students, high school students. If any of you are interested in that, it is on May the 2nd at Foot Field, just a 5K run or walk, so if you want to take a little pat around, that's cool too. So if you'd like more information on that, you can head to our website. It's kenyanceramics.org. Again, that's kenyanceramics.org. Also, you can try to contact me as well. We can give you some information after the talent show. And other than that, we hope to see you around. If you'd like to get involved, we'd be really appreciative of that as well.
Okay, thanks again, everybody.